एहसास न्याय का सबके लिए आकाश न्याय का सबके
Hello everyone, I am Advocate Vanisha D'Souza. Today is World Day of Social Justice. The concept of social justice often refers to human rights. Typically, those who strive for social justice seek to enhance the well-being of individuals through equal access to health care, justice and economic opportunity. We have with us Advocate Ms. Tina Bosley, who will speak on the topic Social Justice and Decent Life for All.
Hello everyone. It is my pleasure to address you all viewers on this channel of Goa State Legal Services Authority's Virtual Juridic Care series on the occasion of World Day of Social Justice. Well, all cultures and traditions have grappled with the question of justice, although they may have interpreted the concept in different ways. For instance, in ancient Indian society, justice was associated with dharma, and maintaining dharma or a just social order was considered to be the primary duty of the kings. In China, Confucius, the famous philosopher, argued that kings should maintain justice by punishing the wrongdoers and rewarding the virtuous. In 4th century BC, Athens in Greece, Plato discussed this issue of justice in his book, The Republic. Through a long dialogue between Socrates and his young friends, Plato examined why we should be just. They observed that people who are unjust seem to be more better off in those better than the just. Those who twisted rules to serve their interest, avoided paying taxes, and were willing to lie and be deceitful were often more successful than those who were truthful and just. If one was smart enough to avoid being caught, then it would seem that being unjust is better than being just. You may have heard people expressing the similar sentiments even today. Socrates reminded these young people that if everyone were to be unjust, if everyone manipulated rules to suit their own interests, no one could be sure of benefiting from injustice. Nobody will be secure, and this was likely to harm all of them. Hence, it is in our own long-term interest to obey the laws and be just. Socrates clarified that we need to understand clearly what justice means in order to figure why it is important to be just. He explained that justice does not only mean doing good to our friends and harm to our enemies or pursuing our own interests. Justice involves the well-being of all people. Just as a doctor is concerned with the well-being of his or her patients, similarly, a just ruler or a just government must be concerned with the well-being of the people. Ensuring the well-being of the people includes giving each person his or her due. Now, what is social justice? Social justice is one of the basic principles for peaceful living. It is fundamental that all people should have equal access to wealth, justice, health, well-being and opportunity. Social justice means availability of equal social opportunities for the development of personality to all the people in society without any discrimination by caste, race, sex, etc. No one should be deprived because of these differences, those social conditions which are essential for social development. Now, World Day of Social Justice or World Social Justice Day is observed on February 20 every year. The main objective of observing World Day of Social Justice is to raise voice against social injustice and to bring the various communities internationally together to eliminate poverty, gender and physical discrimination, illiteracy, religious discrimination to make a socially integrated society. This concept of social justice first arose in 19th century during the Industrial Revolution as attempts were made to promote more egalitarian societies and to reduce the exploitation of certain marginalized groups due to the vast disparity between the rich and the poor at the time. Today, social justice has shifted towards a stronger emphasis on human rights and improving the lives of disadvantaged and marginalized groups that have historically faced discrimination in the society. The United Nations General Assembly decided to observe on February 20 every year as World Day of Social Justice in accordance with the objective and goals of the World Summit for Social Development. The observance of these days started in the year 2009. The theme for this year's World Day of Social Justice is a call for social justice in digital economy. Now, fighting this social inequality on a digital platform is in need of our considering the COVID-19 pandemic. The observance of World Day of Social Justice would support efforts of international community in poverty eradication, the promotion of full employment and decent work, gender equity and access to social well-being and justice for all. I would like to quote here King Martin Luther. Our lives begin to end the day we become silent about things that matter. End quote. If you face any injustice in your life, you can't sit on the sidelines of life and watch injustice. Rather, you need to speak out and consciously push it back. He further stated that injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere. India is among one of the nations that upholds the principle of social justice. Among the objectives stated in the preamble of the Constitution, the people of India resolve to constitute India into a sovereign republic and to secure social, economic and political justice to all its citizens, thus reflecting the hopes and the aspirations of all. Yet enunciating the principles of social justice is one thing, but making it effective is quite another. In order to achieve social justice, we the Indians need to address the myriad of problems that people face in this country because of caste, gender, religion, culture, tradition and others. Now, we need to understand that the social justice are based on certain principles. It is based on five most important principles. Now, which are these principles? To understand more about social justice, we need to understand these five principles. These five principles are access to resources, equity, participation, diversity and human rights. Now, just to brief about these five principles. Now, what is access to resources? Access to resources is an important principle of social justice and refers to the extent to which different socio-economic groups receive equal access to give everyone an equal start in life. Many societies offer a multitude of resources and services for their citizens, such as healthcare, food, shelter, education, and recreational opportunity. But there often exists unequal access to such resources. Next is equity. Equity refers to how individuals are given tools specific to their needs and socio-economic status in order to move towards similar outcomes. It contrasts with equality, where everyone is offered the same tools to move towards the same outcome. Next is participation. What is participation? Participation refers to how everyone in society is given a voice and opportunity to verbalize their opinion and concern and have a role in any decision making that affects their livelihood and standard of living. Social injustice occurs when a small group of individuals makes a decision for a larger group, while some people are unable to voice their opinion. Next is diversity. Understanding diversity and appreciating the value of cultural differences are especially important because policymakers are often better able to construct policies that take into consideration differences that exist among different societal groups. It is important to recognize that some groups face more barriers in society, and by considering the inequities, policymakers and civil servants will be in a stronger position to expand opportunities for marginalized or disadvantaged groups. Discrimination in employment on the basis of factors such as race, gender, ethnicity, age and other characteristics are constant issues in the society, and enforcing policies to countermand discriminatory practices are one way in which diversity is taken into consideration. And lastly, the most important principle of social justice is human rights. Now, this is one of the most important principles of social justice and form a foundational part of the concept. Human rights and social justice are certainly interrelated, and it is impossible for one to exist without the other. Human rights are fundamental to societies that respect the civil, economic, political, cultural, and legal rights of the individual. And governments, organizations, and individuals must be held responsible if they fail to ensure the upholding of these rights. They are extremely important in many societies and are recognized internationally through institutions such as the International Criminal Court and the United Nations Human Rights Council. After India attained independence, the country introduced laws to address the oppression, inequality, and discrimination faced by the historically disadvantaged castes and tribes, and to improve their socio-economic position. These laws are regarded as type of affirmative action that was designed to provide them with the opportunity to access government jobs and be enrolled in higher educational institutions. However, inequality is still rampant in modern India. Now, another disastrous evil that plagued the country and need to be wiped out from the Indian society is female suppression. That is, interlocking complex of lower status and limited opportunities for women as compared with the men in spheres of law, education, the economy and social power. Now, female suppression has been widespread and pervasive over the span of history of India. And although women's status have also been subject to different changes, women are still discriminated against and excluded from decision-making processes. From time they are born, young Indian girls and women are the victims of discrimination and violence. Domestic violence is especially endemic. Around 70% of women in India are victims of domestic violence. In addition, female infanticide, sex-selective abortion, honor killing, dowry-related violence, and death and child marriages are some of the many evils which have proved so difficult to root out despite the constitutional and legal provision that not only grant equality of women but also empower the state to adopt measures for positive discrimination in favor of women. Now, where does the solution lie to all the problem of social injustice? The solution to social injustice lies within us. We should be aware of the expression, the poor, the backward, the social justice, which are being used to undermine standards, to flout norms, and to put institutions to work. We should subject every claim, whether it is made in the name of poor, the backward, whosoever, to rational examination. After it has been in effect for a while, subject every concession to empirical evidence. We should shift from equality of outcomes to equality of opportunities. And in striving towards that, nudge the politicians to move away from the easy option of just decreeing some reservation to doing the detailed and continuous work that positive health requires, the assistance that the disadvantaged needs for availing of equal opportunities. We must bear in mind that if the majority disregards smaller section in the community, it drives them to a rebellion. We should try to refashion the policies of the state on truly secular and liberal principles. The individuals and not the group should be the unit of state policy. Since no state society is static and social processes are constantly changing, a good legal system is one which ensures that laws adapt to the changing situations and ensure social good. Any legal system aiming to ensure good should ensure the basic dignity of the human being and inherent the need of every individual to grow into the fullness of life. The hope of the Indian masses does not lie in legal system alone, but in their conscious awakening and fight for social and economic justice. Knowledge of their legal rights, however, can be an important motivating force in this. Many NGOs and individuals are emerging in different parts of the country to take up the cause of social change. And this change for more just India, where justice will not merely be talked about in intellectual discussions on the intricacies of law or written about in books which the masses can't read, but actually lived and experienced by the majority of the people. The Constitution of India accepts this use of social justice in a wider sense, which includes both social and economical justice. As former Justice, Justice P.B. Gajendra Gadkar put it, "In this sense, social justice holds the aim of equal opportunity to every citizen in the matter of social and economical activities and to prevent inequalities." As a measure to facilitate social justice, India has enacted a Comprehensive Protection of Women from Domestic Violence Act, which recognizes that violence can take various forms, including psychological, physical, and even social. This act provides a legal tool for women to fight violence within the family, both marital and familial abuse. The law seeks to provide support to women victims of domestic violence in form of shelter, medical help, compensation, maintenance order, and custody of children. The Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Scheme is the biggest action for ensuring right to work. The Corporate Social Responsibility in the Companies Act brings a new dimension of sharing profits. The Social Justice and Empowerment Ministry, which caters to the welfare of backward classes and those with disability, has been allocated Rs 11,689 crore, a 28% increase over the previous financial year. An amount of Rs 10,517 crore has been allocated for the Department of Social Justice and Empowerment for this financial year of 2021-22. There has been a rise of 28% from the revised financial budget of the previous financial year. After all this, a question comes to our mind. Is social justice possible in India? The one word answer to this question is yes. But it will be possible only with the abolition of inequalities associated with gender, caste, religion, wealth, title, and opportunity. Once Helen Keller said, and I quote her, "Until the great mass of people shall be filled with the sense of responsibility for each other's welfare, social justice can never be attained." And lastly, to quote former Prime Minister, late Shri Atal Bihari Vajpayee, "Freedom is incomplete without social justice." Thank you.
Social justice promotes fairness and equity across many aspects of society. For example, it promotes equal economic, educational, and workplace opportunities. Perhaps the most important principle in this discussion, human rights, are inherent to all individuals, regardless of the socio-economic status. Human rights and social justice are inevitably intertwined, and it's impossible to have one without the other. You just heard Advocate Ms. Tina Bosley speak on the topic Social Justice and Decent Life for All. Before departing, let me remind you to like, share, and subscribe to Goa State Legal Services Authority's channel. Thank you for joining us.
राष्ट्रीय न्यायिक सेवा प्राधिकरण
न्यायालयातल्या कारवाई खातीर बरो वकील मेळून दिता.
वेळार योग्य कायदा खालची मदत आणि सल्लो दिता.
लोक अदालत द्वारा चढ काळच्या केसीक बेगीन सोपयता.
आणि ते बी सांगे मोफत.
राष्ट्रीय न्यायिक सेवा प्राधिकरण बेस बरो न्याय बेस बरो समाज.
अधिक माहिती खातीर लागच्या न्यायालयातल्या न्यायिक सेवा प्राधिकरण कार्यालयाला संपर्क करा
वा टोल फ्री नंबर 1510 चेर फोन करा.